Your parents. But now I want to share some things with you. We're talking about different types of books and reading out loud. And I know series, they mentioned reading books in a series is really powerful for students, because if they find a reading series they really like, it gets them hooked and they can keep reading. And it makes the reading easier because they're not introduced to new settings and characters all the time. You're reading about the same character, which helps. So I brought in some things today. Couldn't carry them all, you guys, so I found a really good way to travel. I like traveling, by the way. You know that? It's a lot of fun. So this is the little bag that they would let me take on the airplane. So instead of going anywhere, I thought I would come here with it today. So I wanted to introduce you guys to some series. How many of you like to read chapter books? I do. How many of you like to read picture books? Some of them are pretty quirky and funny. I still like Mo. You know, the Mo Williams books? Yeah. But anyway, so I just want to introduce some of the things that are in my bag today real quick with you. And I'm going to show you some of the new characters, introduce you to some characters that you might not have seen before. And so I'm going to start out with, how many of you guys and gals like sports? What kind of sports are there? Give me a few. Yell out a few sports. Is an author that writes about sporting books, and it says if you're looking for a fast-paced, action-packed sports novel, this is the guy to turn to. He has written over 100 books. A lot of books. I thought that was a lot of books. So I'm going to give you kind of a quick peek into this one. Hot Shot. What kind of book is this? What sport?
Basketball.
Okay. And on this one it says, this book, Julian Price was with the Stars, Thunder, of the Tornadoes. But when he joins a new team after his family moves, he suddenly finds himself as the star bench warmer. Do you know what a bench warmer is? How many of you like to be, how many of you like that term, bench warmer? Are you adults? When you have to sit on the bench and you can't get in, and that's not fun, especially if you like to play. So it turns out that the Warriors, where he moved to that team, already have a starting center, Paul Boyd, who has no intention of sharing the court with Julian. The coach? It's no help either, because Paul is his son. So Julian may have to take some drastic measures if he's going to get back into the game. But is he to blame when Paul winds up in the hospital? So if you look at these, here are some of his books. And you know what? I only pulled a few from Mr. Ogle's library shelf. See, this one's about basketball. Football, another.
Basketball.
Soccer. And there's one with? Mountain biking. Yeah, kind of cool. That's kind of extreme. That one can get kind of crazy. All right, and I have another series that I want you to introduce you to. To get the words out of my mouth. I chose this one. How many of you have seen this series? How many of you like this one? There are a lot of books in this series, and this one's by Dan Gutman. It's from the Why Weird School series. Okay. It's called Coach Hyatt is a Riot, and I kind of like this. I chose this book because I have four boys. My boys' response. If all of a sudden I showed up as the coach, woo, it would be kind of scary. But so maybe you guys feel like this main character AJ does about school. My name's AJ, and I love school. Going to school is just so much fun. I wish I could go to school at night. I wish I could go to school on the weekend. I wish we never had vacations. How many of you are like AJ? Just kidding. I hate school. Do you know what I'd rather do than go to school? I would rather eat a dead bug sandwich. No, 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 no. a live bug sandwich. Yes, that would be even worse than a dead bug sandwich. Because the bugs would still be moving around in the sandwich while I was eating it. Disgusting. But even more disgusting than eating a live bug sandwich is going to school. I don't eat everything, you know. Some stuff I love, like video games and skateboarding and trick biking. I'll tell you, which is crazy. She wants the boys to do push-ups in the mud. She wants them to pick up a car. And first of all, she wants to put girls on the team. You'll never believe in a million hundred years what happens. And girls, I'll give you a clue. There's some girl color in this book. So with that, and so, we have Coach Hyatt is all right. Miss Lizzie is dizzy. I mean, there's quite a few. Dr. Brad has gone mad. What's your name, Brad? All right. Miss Jaffy is Daffy. How about Miss Mary is Scary? Do we have any Marys here? Hey, this is good. These are some really fun books. So, definitely something you want to check out. And since, school seems to be the theme right now because these are school ones. I've got another series I want to quick show you. It's the Heidi Heckelbeck series.
What?
Have you heard of these?
No.
These are kind of cool. They've got some fun little illustrations in here. But these are another one by Wanda Coven. And what are some kind of problems that we could have in school? Have you ever had any problems in school?
No.
Do kids face any problems? Yes, like what? Hard math tests.
Pop quiz.
Pop quiz? You guys get pop quizzes? Wow.
Maybe we should start.
How about sometimes lunch doesn't taste the best, or maybe you're an artist, yes. Something goes wrong? Well, Heidi, I'm going to give you a little bit of Heidi's day here, okay? Heidi Heckelbeck seems like any other 8-year-old. She kind of has a fun name, but she has a secret. She has secret powers. Careful to keep her powers hidden, but excited to use them all the same. Heidi's learning to live like any other kid. But Heidi and her brother Henry have always been homeschooled until now. But Heidi's not happy about attending Brewster Elementary, especially not when Meanie Melanie Mapplethorpe turns Heidi's first day of school into a nightmare by announcing that Heidi is smelly and by ruining her art project. Heidi feels horrible and never wants to go back to school. But while sulking in her room, she remembers her special medallion and book of spells. With a little bit of carefully concealed magic, Heidi might be able to give Melanie a taste. So here's another series that you might want to check out and get into. Do you guys like a good mystery?
Yeah.
How many of you know about the Boxcar Children?
Oh yeah!
Oh yeah! All right. How many of you adults know about the Boxcar Children?
Oh yeah!
Oh yeah! Turn around, look. Okay. You know, I'm just gonna say, guys and gals, this series has not gone away, and it was one of my favorite series when I was growing up as a kid. Who knows some of the characters? Henry. Who else? That J, that's what you're looking for. Benny? Oh, Benny's pretty good. He's a little new, isn't he?
Violet,
awesome.
Watch.
And who is the one that saved him?
Grandfather.
So it's a story about four kids that were orphaned and they lived in a boxcar and they thought their grandfather was mean, but he wound up being a pretty cool dude who had a lot of money, right? Yeah, and so the Boxcar Children go on to live with their grandfather, Eldon, and they go on exciting mysteries. And this one's kind of cool. I thought I'd pull this one, The Mystery of the Runaway Ghost. Because it kind of goes right with the season, doesn't it? A little bit. So, and this one is when the Eldons visit their friend Fran in Wisconsin. This story takes place in Wisconsin. Pretty cool. story of the runaway ghost. Fran's family ghost hasn't been spotted in years. But the Aldens still shiver at the spooky tale of the ghost's bell ringing after dark. Then, Violet hears a mysterious ring, and the children start to wonder, could the runaway ghost be? They go on all sorts of awesome little mystery solving. So there are more books. I think if you read them when you were younger, there are still more that you haven't seen yet. So there's this one. Or how about another set of mysteries? These ones are newer, and they were not around when I was younger. But that means that they just keep writing more and more good books. Cam Jansen.
Oh,
how many of you read? Cam. You know what? Her name really isn't Cam. Did you know that?
I knew that.
You knew that? Her name is Jennifer, but she has one of those photographic memories. Do you know what that is?
Yeah.
Do any of you have one of those? Do you wish you had one of those before you took a test? Oh yeah, I wish I could be like, you know, that's why as adults, when we have to remember something, we often go like this. We're just looking for help out of nowhere. That's not sure to come up. So anyway, her name, she got the nickname, the camera, because of her photographic memory. And I got shortened to Cam. But this one is a pretty cool series too. I'm gonna move it along. I'm not gonna share the expert then. This one I have to share because this one is really cool, you guys. The I Survive series. And I know that your teachers mentioned that one. And this is really cool. So I was at the pop concert last night, you guys and gals, and there was a seventh grader sitting behind me. And you know, teachers bring their homework with them. And I had these books sitting like this on my chair. Before I knew it, like the seventh grader snatched this book under my chair. And the seventh grader is like looking through the book. And I like turn around like, oh, it's okay, you can read my book. Do you like that book? And he's like, oh, these were the coolest books. So then I go home and I spread my homework out on the counter and my husband snatches up the book. And I'm like, I needed to use it to write some things down. But he walks off in the living room and he's reading it. And this is great because you know what, guys and girls? How many of you have read these books? How many of you understood them? You know what my husband does for a living? He's an engineer. And he came back in and said, that was a pretty good book. I was a little confused at first. It was a little bit of a hard read, but I figured it out because it does something really cool. And I really had to think about which one I wanted to share with you. But for the parents that don't know, they are awesome. They're like historical fiction books where they take a character and they go back into a series of time and tell you about the time and what it was like. And at the end of the book, do you remember like the cool thing is it has like little facts and things about the actual event that you can read more about in the history. So, and then they put another snag in, don't they? Most of the time they put the next one in there so you can get snagged by it. But with the I Survive, the shark attacks of 1916. You read that one? It starts off with July 12, 1916. Elm Hills, New Jersey. The Mattawan Creek. A feeling of terror came up over 10-year-old Chet Wasserow. A chill deep down in his bones. He had been swimming in the Mattawan Creek by himself. But he had the idea that someone, and then he saw it, a large gray fin, slicing through the water like a knife. What was that? Could it really be? Everybody help me out. Was impossible. Elms Hills was miles and miles from the ocean. How could a shark find its way into this? There was no way. But now Chet could see it coming toward him. The gigantic shark, bigger than Chet himself, with black eyes staring up through the water. Killer eyes. Chet dove toward the shore, pounding through the water, kicking with all his might. His feet touched the bottom. He was running now, looking over his shoulder. The shark was right behind him, its huge jaws wide open, its white dagger teeth gleaming blood red. And then it goes back in time and it tells you what happened before this event that leads all up to it. And then it lets you know, does he survive?
Yeah.
He survives because it's called the I Survive series. So you won't have bad dreams when you're done. But these are really cool books. something that is definitely worth checking out. And you know what? I have two extra copies of my own. These are all books you'll find in Mr. Ogle's library. So, Mrs. Pino, this one you can put in your classroom library. And Mrs. Schmidt, you can put this one in your classroom library. Whew! That was a lot of different books to cover, wasn't it? My suitcase is empty. I think your tummies might be kind of empty. And you might be thinking we should go have breakfast.
Yeah.
How many of you think we should have breakfast? Yeah. One last series, though. It's called the Disgusting, Totally Disgusting series. And this one is nonfiction, and it has some pretty cool stuff in it. Mr. Ogle has these in his library. And this one is titled Disgusting Foods. But you know what? We're going to go eat, so I'm not going to show you all the foods that are on this book. You're going to have to check it out yourself. So with that, parents, thank you so much for your time, and thank you for coming.